الحمد لله، وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، وأشهد أن نبينا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم تسليما. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in his book, وَكَذَلِكَ نُوَلِّي بَعْضَ الظَّالِمِينَ بَعْضًا جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. That this is our way, Allah is saying. This is my way, this is our sunnah, this is our path. We impose tyrants who do unjust to rule tyrants who do unjust. As a punishment for what they earn of sins, of disobedience. This is the sunnah of Allah. This is the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why there is a popular saying, كَمَا تَكُونُ يُوَلَّى عَلَيْكُمْ. You will be ruled by the likes of you. As you act, you deserve. And this is in accordance with many verses of Quran, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in his book, وَمَا أَصَابَكَ مِنْ سَيِّئَةٍ فَمِنْ عِنْدِ نَفْسِكَ. Whatever calamity, whatever disaster, whatever problem occurs upon you, it is because of what your hands have earned, the sins, the sins. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِ. Allah does not change the state of a people until they change their state. Allah will not change the good and the nourishing and the happy life of you until you change yourselves from obedient worshippers of Allah to disobedient. And also, He will change your condition from mischievousness, from misery, from pain to happiness if you switch from your evil, you leave your evil and become pious. This is the sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Unfortunately, the people, the Muslims nowadays, have taken things upside down. They want to change in a way that is opposite to what Allah is requiring for us. Allah says, if you want to get rid of the unjust, then start by yourselves. Change yourselves from being unjust, unjust to Allah, unjust to yourselves. Get rid of the sins. Repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no way to escape from the wrath of Allah except by going back to Him. No way. So let's not fool ourselves, and let's not look right and left when we have the solution in between our hands, the book of Allah and the sunnah of the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let us act by what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered us, and let us act by what the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have ordered us. The messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has described the situation of this nation towards the end of time, which is like this time that we are in now, that when they deal with riba and do this sin and that sin and that sin, Allah will impose, will send down a humiliation upon them that He will not lift until what? Make demonstrations? Until what? حَتَّى تَرْجِعُوا إِلَىٰ دِينِكُمْ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Allah will not lift this humiliation from you until you go back to the religion. Go back. Back. Why back? Meaning, act upon the religion that was acted upon by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions. That is the only Islam. That was the Islam that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. Today I have completed my favor upon you. Today I have perfected your religion for you. Today I have accepted the Islam, one Islam, one way, as the religion for you. So my dear brothers and sisters, again, let's not fool ourselves. Let's not go left and right. Let's not resemble the non-Muslims, the kafirs, the mushriks, the Christians, the Jews. Let's not resemble them. The only way is to act upon the orders of Allah and the sunnah of the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. الحمد لله وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن نبينا محمدًا عبده ورسوله. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, looking back at the history of Islam, in the beginning of Islam, when the Muslims were few in number in Mecca, surrounding the beloved messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, facing all kinds of torture and humiliation from the mushriks, from the worshippers of the idols. Some of the youth came to the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They asked him permission to fight. Fight, jihad, this is something good. But what did Allah say? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed, كفوا أيديكم وأقيموا الصلاة. كفوا أيديكم. Hold back your hands. Don't fight. This is not the time. You have a way to go. You have to prepare yourselves. You have to act upon the orders of Allah to increase your faith. As Aisha رضي الله عنها said, as narrated by Sahih al-Bukhari, كان ينزل من القرآن وأنا جارية ألعب بل الساعة موعدهم والساعة أدهى وأمر. تقول لو نزل في ذاك الوقت لا تقربوا الخمر لقالوا لا ندع الخمر أبدا. الله أكبر. عائشة رضي الله عنها ذي صديقة the daughter of the صديق رضي الله عنهما the beloved the most beloved to the خليل of Allah the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. She said when I was a little girl playing in Mecca in the beginning of Islam such verses were coming down. The verses warning us against the horrible, the horror of the day of judgment, to increase the faith in our hearts, to increase the fear of Allah in our hearts, to prepare for the orders of Allah that will come later. Most of the orders, most of all the halal and haram was not revealed in Mecca. It was revealed in Medina. In Mecca, mostly Tawheed and faith. Tawheed and faith. Tawheed and faith. This is the way we have to prepare ourselves. The Muslims nowadays need preparation. They need to prepare themselves in their faith and materially also. We cannot be dependent on Jews and Christians and then when we want to fight them with the weapons that they made for us. We cannot do that. This is not the right way. Somebody might say, oh, how long we have to wait? Well, if you wait 100 years, 200 years, so what? You are acting by the orders of Allah. So what? You will be dying worshipping Allah. And worshipping Allah can be many ways, alhamdulillah. How many of us have khushu' in salat? How many? And khushu' is the only obligation in salat that will cause your salat to be rewarded. The more khushu' you have, the more reward. If you have no khushu', no reward. And khushu' is easy, and yet we don't achieve it. What is khushu'? Khushu' is to be heart attendant in salat. Ya akhi, for 5 minutes, my sister, for 5 minutes, don't think of cars, makeup, this, that, clothes, this, that. Don't think. Think of what you're saying. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Allahu Akbar. What a beautiful meaning. Think of what you're saying. Think of your moves. You are kneeling to Allah. You are humbling yourself. What does this remind you of? That He is your Lord. He is your Master. He is the one whom you should please. He is the one whom you should fear. This is khushu'. 5 minutes. And if you do it, you will get the reward of your salat. And your salat will be fruitful, as Allah mentioned. إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. Salat indeed forbids you from bad actions, from evil actions. How many of us nowadays, his salat forbid him? How many? We see people make salat. And then after the salat, they treat each other like treating kafirs. Well, go away. No, this, that. Where? Where are the Islamic morals? Where is the humbleness for your brother? Where is the mercy between you Muslims, brothers? Where is the truthfulness in talk? Where is the honesty? Nothing exists. And we want to put the blame on 50 figures or 60 figures who are the rulers or something like this. They take their blame. No problem. Nothing is wasted with Allah. And their crime is worse because they are responsible for nations. But the way to correct is not to start from the top. The way to correct is to start with ourselves. But we are, unfortunately, I say it, including myself, we are cowards. We don't dare to change ourselves. We want to stay as we are and keep blaming others. This is not the way. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to that which is the best and make us act upon what pleases Him and make us act in the way that pleases Him. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وتب علينا وعافنا وأصلح لنا شأننا كله. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم وارحم أموات المسلمين. اللهم وشاف مرضى المسلمين. اللهم واهد ضال المسلمين. اللهم ردنا إلى دينك الحق ردا جميلا. اللهم ردنا إلى دينك الحق ردا جميلا. اللهم إنا تبنا إليك. اللهم اقبل توبتنا واغسل حوبتنا وعافنا وشافنا. وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. وأقم الصلاة.